Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome to the second day of my week featuring Penny Black. For today's Christmas card, I will be using this adorable stamp set and I am going to stamp it with archival ink. I am doing so because I will be using Prismacolor pencils to color the image as well as add a little bit of Gamsol to do the blending. When I am coloring with my Prismacolor pencils, I don't feel like I have to blend everything with the Gamsol. So you will see that I will use the Gamsol technique in some areas, but I won't in others. So I am starting out by coloring the hat with three different shades of red. I am starting out with my darkest color, now have moved to my middle color, and as you can see I am not pressing the pencil at all. And now that I think that I am feeling confident that I can commit to those colors, I am pressing harder. So I'm going back again to my darker color, now to my middle color, my medium color, and then I will go ahead and use my lightest color at the edge of the hat. So I will not be using any Gamsol in this area because I think that it's nicely blended and I really like the effect. For her stripes I am skipping the middle color, so I am using only the lighter and the darkest color, the darkest at the edges of the stripes and the lighter at the center. For the white stripes, I will be adding just a little bit of gray on the edges and blend it all out with white pencil. You probably can't tell the difference here, but I have added just a little bit of shading at the edges of her, the white part of her hat. But I think with all that lighting on my crafting area, you can't really tell where all this shading is. So now I am going to color her face and then I will move on to the little bear. I am going to put on some music while I am coloring and I'll catch you later once my image is ready. Only for the bear, I am going to do the blending technique with Gamsol. So I'm just dipping my stamp in the Gamsol and I will blend out all of the three colors that I have used for shading the little bear. Notice how I stay on the edges of the little bear and I don't touch at all the white area since I don't want to lose that light. I am going to use a very thin black marker and I'm going over the nose as well as the eyes, just because by using the pencils with all that pigment on top, they seemed a little bit faded. I'm also doing some strokes there for her hair, and my image is ready. All that's left to do is to add a little bit of shading at the bottom of the bear and the little girl, just to ground them somehow. So I am using a brown pencil, which I am going to blend out with my Gamsol. I really love coloring my images with Prismacolor pencils because I think that they are easy to use and I find this very relaxing. So now that I have the ground there, I am going to use my scissors and go all around the image to cut it out. As always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below in the description area if you're watching on YouTube, but you can always find the full list of supplies on my blog. I am going to use my craft knife and I'm going to cut out that white space under her hat, and once that's done, I am ready to go ahead and start working on my card base. I am working on a self-healing mat, and this makes using the craft knife really easy, and also I am not pressing too hard, I just go over and over again the same area until it's nicely cut. And as always, I am going to use a black marker to go all around the edges of my image, and this is going to add a black edge, and it will make it as if I have cut out the image perfectly. This is a beautiful and intricate metal die by Penny Black, which I am going to cut for my background. Now, if you want to cut these intricate dies, it's always a nice idea to use a metal plate adapter, like I am doing now. So I first added the metal adapter, and now I am going to create my sandwich as usual. I'm going to run it through my Sizzix machine, and you will see that everything is going to be cut out perfectly. Everything is cut out, but I need to take my time and push everything so it separates. Now, the final result is really beautiful, and I decided to go all over it with my Versamark ink, and then I used my embossing powder. The embossing powder that I have used was a mix of silver with dark green. And as I was doing the embossing, my camera stopped recording, so you will see the final result, but I will link down below in the supplies the embossing powder that I have used. Now I have this scrap piece of paper, which was originally green, but I didn't like the shade of it, so I am going all over it again with my distress ink, and I am adding forest moss to make it even darker. And the idea is to stick this die cut on top of that green pattern paper. To stick this down, I am using my matte medium gel, and I am applying the gel as a glue at the back with my brush. What is great about using a matte medium as a glue is that once it dries, you cannot tell where the glue was, even if it seeps under your design, because it does not add any gloss at all. I have put a stamping block on top just to make sure that everything is nicely pressed down, and now I am going to stick my focal point on top of my panel. I am using some foam tape at the back, which is going to hold my image nicely, and at the same time it is going to add a little bit of dimension. I am going to stick it at the very bottom of my card. For my card base, I have chosen a red that matches perfectly the red on my card. It is a side folding card and it's 4.25 by 5.5. To stick the panel on top, I am using my ATG gun, and I am being generous just because there are many elements and I want to be nice and sturdy and hold on for the mail. Using a die cut as a background, it doesn't leave me any space for stamping my sentiment. So instead, I am going to use as a sentiment this banner from an older Penny Black collection. This is called Christmas Banners, and I am going to stamp it with Versamark ink on top of this red cardstock. This is exactly the same cardstock as the card base. And I'm going to white emboss it. Actually, this is vanilla embossing powder. It's slightly off-white. And I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the banner. I will use foam tape at the back of the banner, and I'm going to stick it at the very top of my card. And when it comes to Christmas cards, I really love the traditional Christmas colors, so I am using again and again greens and reds on my cards. So my card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to add just a little bit of finishing touch by using my Wing of Stella clear glitter pen. So I am going to add a little bit of shimmer on the bow as well as on the red hat. And that was the cards for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to join me tomorrow for another card featuring Penny Black stamps. Here are some close-up photos on the card. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here is the first card that I made for this fun week featuring Penny Black. Click on the video to watch it, or if you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find a link to this video just below in the description area, or you can click the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching.